people in this room, your passion, your belief in me, and Republicans and independents outside this room, you sent me to Congress to be your independent voice. Now guess what, folks? They don't like it now. They want me gone. So the super PACs are flying us again. It's deja vu all over again. I'll tell you what, those super PAC ads, they don't vote. They don't knock on doors. They don't call people out.
Secretary of State that we've ever had out this time.
and what a pleasure it was. What a pleasure it was for me to be able to work with him and all the wonderful things that we got done together. We succeeded because we knew that serving the American people was not about partisanship, and we're not to try to destroy the other side, which is so prevalent today. We knew that Monroe and Erie and Niagara counties would succeed when we passed laws and got our work in Washington done. How about that for a novel idea? Unfortunately, the arrival of the next administration undid a decade worth of progress and economic growth, and the voters who were wanting bipartisan cooperation that they had seen under Clinton, the Republicans in Washington gave us an extreme agenda, as Kathy mentioned, in 2010, that broke our economy and grew our debt. When this failed agenda led to economic collapse, the Americans said enough is enough. For the past 4 years, I've been working with Kathy and President Obama to climb our way out of this. We're not there yet, but we know that there are better days ahead. So we fought together, all of us. Thank you.
The Secretary of State is one of only two people, the other being the Secretary of Defense in our government, who by my tradition cannot participate in electoral politics. But I got a call, he didn't really get this morning. She said, let me tell him I love him up there. And I love him.
So, Kathy said,
0% of the time. So, if you want to get a Tea Party extremist in the house, you should vote for him. If you want someone who gets something done, whether you're a Democrat, an Independent, or Republican, you got to elect Kathy Hochul.
But that's not enough for them.
Did any beneficiary leave this meeting with them?
No.
What happened? A panel of doctors and other people who study this stuff said, you've got too much inflation living in here. We're getting better at delivering health care. We're going to bring the inflation rate down. And you've guaranteed profit margins that are way too high for the Medicare Advantage program. You know, where you pay a little more and they give you some preventive services as well as regular Medicare. So they took that money and they closed the donut hole, which thousands of New Yorkers called into. It cost them $600 a year. And they made it affordable for insurance companies to give health insurance to families with pre-existing conditions. And look, this has already been done. So if it was the end of the world, all the stuff that Governor Romney says, well, you'd see it. I mean, people are probably dead right here tonight. So what happened to that Medicare Advantage program? We had more insurance companies than ever before wanted to get it. 17% more people enrolled in it, and the cost to the people went down 16%.
Well, where's your projected expenses and
prophet said, I'll tell you in a couple of years. Governor, you run me out of the office. Mitt Romney, the businessman, they wouldn't give Mitt Romney's budget any money, and you shouldn't give him your vote because of that. but most of us parents work. And they're not all minority voters who normally vote Democrat. A lot of them are African American and Latino, but most of them are white. This is a program designed to help support work and family. Then the other 61% of Medicare, Medicaid, you know what it goes to? It goes to thousands of New York seniors on Medicare who have to live in nursing homes and have spent that in private resources, so the nursing home bill is paid for by Medicaid. You really want it? You want me to want who pays the 25% that gets thrown out of the nursing home? That's what's in the line, brother. That's what this presidential campaign is about. That's what their opponents will vote for unless you're reelected. If you care about that, you got to vote for Kathy Hochul and you got to vote for Louise Long.
Starting next year, this is the plan for a minute.
6% of their income of 250 people.
Thank you.